Sori.
That's Booty.
And Culpy and Ghosty. He's chilling out in the Middle America mug. Oh, speaking of Middle America, if you're looking for any of our gear, we have Middle America gear. We have, you know, Sori secret shirts. Maybe you're sick because of your secrets.
Maybe you're sick because of your secrets.
Those are all, and like lots of other things, are all for sale in our Teespring store. And you can find the link in our description. It'll bring you right over there. So.
That's all. All we ask is that if you do get a shirt or a mug or a hoodie, take a picture with it so that we can feature you on
it
the
It is a great way to get featured in one of our videos. So far, we've featured everybody that sent us their picture.
Yep.
If we didn't feature you and you sent us the picture, resend it to us because we might have missed. We get lots of different emails. Okay, anyway, the other thing is if you're a band and you want to have your band reviewed by us, we have a certain price for that. But if your band purchases Sori Secret shirts and you're all wearing it and you're doing a band pose and you send that to us, we will do a song review for you for free. So that will be very fun the first time we get that.
Oh, I didn't know about this deal. Did you just come up with
it
just now?
I did. I just came up with it. Yeah.
Okay. I approve, I guess. For time and topical political commentary, you can hit us up in the Middle America with Vinny and Sori. Okay, so this is from the True Cult Alliance, headed up by the big homie Damon Sage.
Yes.
This is all the way back at April 8th, a low upper.
I know. May 8th.
This is a band from Zurich, Switzerland, formed by Tom Warrior after his departure from the band Celtic Frost. I've heard of Celtic Frost, I think.
Me too. Yeah.
So they're black metal, doom, goth. If you want to be part of a Patreon group, it starts at $1. Get you into the gate.
Yep.
You pull your points and you get hooked up with the True Cult is the most mysterious. I'm pretty sure they're on Discord. I never hear from any of them other than Damon Sage, and then
yeah,
he goes
and
back.
And even Damon Sage is like, do you know what Damon Sage looks like?
No, I don't know what he looks like, and I don't know what he sounds like.
Can you guess what he looks like? What do you picture?
I think he's the Craig from Slipknot.
Pull Craig from Slipknot up. I don't know what that... The guy never talks.
I met Slipknot. I was hanging out with them for a little bit, and Craig wouldn't say anything.
Okay, he's on the, like, thinner side. Kind of like... More like Zen. Look like Zen from Cradle of Filth a little bit.
Zen is not Cradle of Filth.
I got distracted. Because baby, you have something stuck in your teeth, and I was thinking, should I tell him? Should I not tell him?
That's fine. Unhand me.
It's Zen from the Neal Vascaris is actually what I was thinking. But not as tall as Zen, like a shorter version, and not somebody who wears so much like I picture him wearing some reds.
All right. So if you want in on that group, then that's how you get there. All right. This is Triptychon Aurore.
Yeah, that's a... Sounds interesting. It sounds like something that you would come to me and be like, I one day would like to try Triptychon.
That's true. That's true.
Does it take a sage or how do you...
You ready?
Shaman.
Go!
No, I'm the one that decides when we go. Go.
We'll be right back.
It had an addictive sound to the music. To me anyway. Like, yeah. Kinda.
Yeah, that's a song I could listen to on loop.
Yeah.
If I was in a certain mood.
Yep.
Get the steam up in the shower. Get one candle out there.
Yep.
And hang out for quite some time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
A spirit wasting away. Like, but I have to be in a certain type of mood to appreciate stuff like that. This is a pretty dangerous song for this band, in the sense that it could be one of those, I could see us going, oh, I hate this, we'll never listen to this band again.
Yeah.
Sometimes when stuff is too, but like I said, I always say there's no rhyme or reason to a lot of this stuff with us.
Well, for me, I know what my rhyme and reason is. My rhyme and reason is my mood. So if that hits me a certain way, like it's all emotion.
I'm not in the mood for this song right now, but I there's a place for it in my mind where I would be in the mood for it. But usually with repetitive songs, like when stuff is like really, really repetitive and not going anywhere, mm-hmm. in the sense of not many progressions, we usually are not good with it.
Yeah.
But there's something about this particular song where I was good with it, and it was just the amount of right. The timing was 6:17. It's kind of a weird number.
Yeah.
But it works, and I genuinely like the song, and this is a song that I would really, really like in a certain type of mood. And it's weird because, you know, it says the mind's tired of war, of misery and pain, a spirit wasting away. You know, like, there is a kind of a time when you want off the train. And you're tired of fighting, and you know. I think that's probably why the song resonated with me so much, because I feel like I've been in conflict and chaos my entire life.
I thought of you so much when that part first started.
Yeah. Yeah, I've been in it my entire life, and for the most part, I've loved it. You know, I've loved every aspect of it. Mm-hmm. You know, from being a kid and. Maybe it was a defense mechanism, I don't know, but seeing all the craziness and chaos, like, I don't really feel like I was traumatized by it. Like, I felt like it was, you know, to some degree it was, like, fun, it was, like, exciting. I remember being a kid and, like, wishing something would pop off because I was bored. But, you know, that's one of when I was in the hospital, that's one of the things that they asked me.
Yeah.
And I remember, and I purposely did not answer the question, honestly, because I thought to myself, because I read, it was like a 500 question thingamajig. So I read all the questions before I answered them. And I noticed
that you are so interesting.
I noticed that all the questions that some of the questions were repeated like 7 or 8 times, and I was like, okay, this is a big one. They're trying to get me. So all the like, it was like one question was like, I get bored. It was like, I get bored if you know something bad isn't happening. And then other times it's like, life seems dull when there's no chaos. That's the same question.
Yeah.
But they're separated by like 300 other questions.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So it was like, I had to make sure. What I did was, the first, I read all 500 questions, and then I found all the doubles and triples and then answered them consistently, and then just did the rest of it. And I came out, because I was trying like hell not to get blue paper. Because I had already been blue papered. So I was trying to get out.
So scary, babe.
So I was trying to get out. And I crushed the test. And then something happened with my mom and the nurse and whatever. And they were like, you're staying. So it's basically like I couldn't go back home. And they were like, we're not going to. They just felt like.
Oh my gosh, babe.
They were like, well, you're good. It's environmental factors. And then what ended up happening was after. They're like, oh, no pathology, you're good. And then I had to stay because the whole thing happened with my mom and the doctor or whatever. And then after a while, they begin to see like, no, something's wrong with this kid.
Honey, that's scary.
Yeah.
That's scary if there's a test that is supposed to tell them whether you need help or you don't. And you master that. You needed help, but you master that test intellectually. So you like trick the...
My brain was really cloudy too, because I was all, well, I had the charcoal. Because
the way that you systematically did that.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But anyway.
Your mind was cloudy when you did that.
Yeah, my brain was
you would be cloudy. Such a scary, horrible, bad person, like, if you used your powers for evil. Like, you know how some people.
I have.
That must have been very scary for...
<I'll do> I love my country.
Whoever was involved.
I love my country.
Wow. But no, I thought of you at the beginning because it wasn't just stuff like that I was thinking about, like just like the overall narrative of your life and the things that have happened, but just how you react and relate to tragedy. You know, like I said, like most people, generally speaking, when they hear about some horrible event, you're like struck like, oh my gosh, there was like a mass shooting or there was a, you know, whatever. But then like, you know, 10, 15 minutes later, like you can go eat your sandwich. You can go on with your life. And you're not like that. When you hear of tragedy, it really, really affects you. And I'm sure that you hear of a lot more tragedy stuff that, like, because you're always on social media, so you must hear about a lot more than, but there are certain ones that really just, like, affect you, like your cousin or your whatever was there. So it's, so I would think that that line right there would even more hit you because it's not just the stuff that has happened to you personally, but also... the way that the world around you affects you because of the way that you view.
Well, it's a strange thing. A lot of the reason that it affects me like that is the fact that I know that 10 minutes later nobody's going to care, and that bothers me almost as much as the tragedy that happened.
Mm-hmm.
And because I've seen the results of what happens in a shooting.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I don't like deaths that are just purposeless. Like, again, Crips and Bloods are fighting each other. It is purposeless in the sense that why? But at the same time, it's like, we're rivals and you killed my friend. Yeah. Da, 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 da. So it's like, okay, that makes sense. It's like, or, you know, war and guys, you know, you're on the other side, I'm on the other side, and, you know, in a different universe, we'd be friends, but now one of us is gonna die.
Mm-hmm.
I understand that, but, like, just random... meanness, somebody goes in and shoots up people are planning on summer vacation or whatever. I don't like stuff like that. You know, civilian people getting killed. I don't like that shit because, you know, you go home and there's all these reminders, somebody's shoes or an answering machine or an email that was unopened. And, you know, Rachel Held Evans, she had like 4 or 5 blogs that she had written that are unreleased. So I was going through my other thread and I saw this article from her and I was like, oh! And like for a split second I was like,
oh.
Well, no, she's dead. It was just, you know, stuff like that. Mm-hmm. I can't stand that stuff. Like the
yeah.
You know, one of somebody that died overseas, he left his mom a message and the calls don't get there like that day. So his body was, they were collecting his body from the plane and she got a message from her son. You know, he's like, Mom, I'm okay, I'm good. You know, so those types of things, I don't like those things are really, and I've seen people, you know, like, your son is dead, you're whatever, and, you know, so, it's a hard pill to swallow that people are going through that, and then people see it, and then they go, ah, and then 10 minutes later, they're worried about, you know, but at the same time, it's like, I can't be mad at people for that. People have to survive. They can't have their entire days ruined all the time over stuff. You know what I mean? Like, people have to live, you know? So you...
Well, again, this is the whole social media age, because back in the day, you didn't find out about everything that was going on.
Right.
You know, everything, you know, it went by mail or whatever, you know?
Right.
The majority of our existence hasn't been where we can see everything, not even just in our own country, but all over the place.
Right.
You know, in 3 scrolls, you can see so many atrocities.
Yeah.
That.
Yeah, I agree. And again, and it's weird because if it's in your kind of circle, then the reactions are different.
Of course.
And then, of course, you see the ugliest forms of, you know, like I saw the ugliness in people that I like. But, you know, when the whole New Zealand thing happened, I saw a bunch of human ugliness there, man. You know, when those Muslims got shot up, you know.
Oh, yeah. Mm.
And you're like.
Yeah.
And then I say to myself, well, you know, honestly, there's some people that the doctrine of original sin keeps me friends with them. And if I didn't believe that, I would never talk to them ever again.
Yeah.
You know, like, I look at stuff sometimes, I'm like, how could you be that fucking insensitive and heartless? And then I go, well.
Human nature.
They were born that way.
Yeah.
And so it kind of gives me an out to say, okay, I could still be this person's friend. But if I didn't believe that, then
yeah.
I would tell them I would never want to speak to you ever again.
Yeah.
But, so it gets heavy. And I think that was kind of, you know, and then you kind of look at your own things and you've done things to people and I'm talking to myself, like you've put people in those situations too. So...
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's all.
Yeah, most of us have, you know, more grace for ourselves than we do for our neighbor.
Yeah. Yeah, but the spirit wasting away, that's really interesting, you know, it's like, I don't know what this guy believes, or the majority of our crew are atheistic in their understanding. So the refrain of the spirit wasting away, which is really the fulcrum of the entire song, it's repeated multiple times.
Mm-hmm.
and the song ends that way.
Yeah.
I think it's a really important point of that song. It's like, whoa, you do believe in spirit.
Yeah, it made me kind of think of the, who was it? Was it, it's not Job, it's, and I can't remember his name right now. Lot? It said that he, like,
it vexed his righteous spirit.
His righteous spirit was vexed because of everything that he was seeing within
yeah.
the city, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
So it made me think of that. I have so many bug bites. We were out by our friend's fire last night and, like, I got eaten alive. And so I'm like, I can't stop scratching. Okay. But that, it made me think of that. Like, there is, that does happen, you know? Spiritually, you can be in a very bad place because of the things that you've seen or the things you participated in, and
yeah.
just being far from God, because God is the one that renews our spirits and cleanses our spirits and stuff like that. So sometimes we get so focused on, like, our body or, like, mentally what's going on with us, and just completely, like, your spirit just kind of gets thrown to the wayside.
Well, yeah, I mean,
it's a part of who you are.
Yeah, and I think there's, you know, there was this big thing in evangelicalism about 10 years ago called soul care, where it was kind of focused exclusively on that.
On your spirit?
Yeah, and it never really took off because, you know, evangelicals get funny when, what do you mean soul care? What are you trying to say? Yeah. but I think everybody...
We can be a superstitious people.
I don't care what you say. Okay, you want to put all metaphysics in the brain? Fine, go for it. I'm not going to argue with you. Mm-hmm. But all I will say is that you know that there's an immaterial part of being a human.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah. What happens is when people are in unguarded moments, they say things like this. Mm-hmm. But then when they're around their theistic friends, they'll say, oh, it's all in your brain. It's all in your mind. Okay. Mm-hmm. Let's go with that. And... Like, but it's still, this is still a way of caring for the soul. Now, I mean, it could be, it could have a deleterious effect because it's a kind of a depressing type of song. Because of the, you know, the progressions of the chords and the mm-hmm. tempo, you know, you can make a song sound sad. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, I think it's good to acknowledge that we all feel, and I think this song is more relevant to our generation than any other generation, as far as like wasting away and just the attrition, the weariness of days, you know, like, because we see so much just horribleness and we've lost so much of our humanity.
Yeah.
That... You know, I think this is an important song.
I would agree with that, yeah.
You know, like, it's one of the ways that people take care of their souls when mm-hmm. they're in a bad space. So, I think, you know, I appreciate it.
I think, too, like, when it says, like, okay, it says, in this misery, the weariness of days, a life turned, what is that word? Relict?
Relict.
What's that mean?
It looks like if you take off that T, mm-hmm. it becomes relic. Mm-hmm. And a relic is like the bones of a, you know, a saint, you know, it's a relic.
Yeah.
So that your life is basically turned into a relic, I'm assuming is what that means.
Nothing else remains. Back up here, it says in this agony, unable to breathe, calm, you know, it just goes on. So it's... When it's saying all those things and then it goes into a spirit wasting away, you think, okay, like all those things... like led to the fact that their spirit feels like it's wasting away.
Right.
But is it that, or could you reverse it and you say, okay, the spirit is wasting away, and so that's why the person's outlook is like that. There's misery and pain, I'm wasting away, there's no, you know, there's nothing else remains and stuff like that. You know what I mean? Like when your spirit is wasting away, then all the rest of everything just seems to be so
right.
dead.
Right, that's a good point. Because when your spirit is strong,
right,
when you're in the midst of all that, it doesn't affect you that way. You say, let's find a way to solve this problem. Let's fix this. Let's, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
You know, so, yeah, I agree. That's very true. It's sort of cart before horse. But mm-hmm. most of us experience it the other way.
Well, I think the reason that
we don't know it, though.
We don't realize where our spirit is at. And so then we think, oh, it's all of those things.
Right. Right.
Life is different when your spirit is well and healthy
right.
than when your spirit is not.
Right.
It
right.
makes a huge difference.
It's absolutely true. For sure. Very unique song. What do you give it?
Ooh.
8.9. And 9.3 for me. It's a good song. Mm-hmm. I appreciated it. I will put much use to it. The next time I hear about some active shooter in my country, I get to read about my countrymen being blasted into smithereens, and then I can read of people defending guns or blaming guns, or the whole thing is just terrible.
Yeah.
Terrible. But much love to everybody. All right. 9.2. Would you give it again?
8.9?
8.9, I think.
Yeah. You gave it a 9.3, but you just switched it to a 9.2?
9.3.
Oh, okay. 9.2. I'll throw in with you.
Then out.
Sorry, out.
Gone.